statements made during this broadcast regarding products or the claims made about specific products have not been evaluated by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. Products and treatments discussed are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent disease. Make your physician aware of all nutritional supplements used and immediately notify your physician if you have any health concern or undiagnosed sign or symptom. Let's Talk Nutrition is a health talk show that features scientists, authors, nutrition specialists, personal trainers, holistic healers, and experts in traditional, natural, and integrative medicine. Listen for a chance to win daily prizes and follow Let's Talk Nutrition on Facebook and Instagram at Let's Talk Nutrition or on Twitter at LTN Radio. It's time for some inspiration. Tune in to get fit and healthy. It's time to talk about nutrition. Nutrition for your body, your mind, your spirit. It's time to talk about proper exercise, stress relief, eating well, and supplementation to help. Get ready to take charge of your health because your health is your wealth and the wealth of those who care about and love you. It's time for Let's Talk Nutrition with Dr. Michael Garko. Welcome to the show.
Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. Thanks for tuning in today. Tune in and stay at the same time. Hope you're having a good day, good start to your day, wherever and however you may be listening or watching the show and whatever you may be doing. You know, driving, making breakfast, lunch, who knows, dinner, because this show is syndicated across the U.S., including Hawaii, does play in different times in different markets, so you have to check your local listings. It's always live, 9 a.m. to 11 p.m., 9 a.m. to 11 a.m., Monday through Friday. And support your local radio station that airs this show. Please do that. Visit letstalknutrition.com. Everything's on demand there. It's a virtual, literally a virtual library of health talk and wonderful information from great experts, Dr. Alan Logan being one of them. He's on in the first hour. Maggie Johnle's on in the second hour. We're going to talk about the gut-brain connection. We'll see what that's all about. Some of you know, probably more than some, maybe a lot, know a lot about the gut-brain connection. In the area of neuroscience, this is really, it's not a new line of research, but relatively speaking to some others, it's relatively new. Still learning a lot about how your gut is connected, how your gut and brain are interconnected. I could think of a lot of one-liners with this, but I'm going to avoid it, get into trouble. So we're going to talk about that today and why that is of any practical importance to you. So what? You might ask, how will my life appreciably change if I know something about this? The answer is maybe a lot. I usually keep my promises, you know. We deliver. In the spirit of one of my favorite foods, the pizza man delivers. Right? You like pizza. Don't you like pizza, Josh?
Yeah, I love pizza. Chicken Alfredo pizza.
Oh, yeah, you and that Alfredo. By the way, I thought about that yesterday.
Just kidding.
Josh likes Alfredo whatever. And when you order Alfredo, it's not the pasta that makes it Alfredo, my man. It's the sauce.
Yes.
The white creamy sauce.
Yeah, good stuff.
Which is loaded with fat. Which leads me to my story that I want to report on, and it's trending. Bring Dr. Alan Logan on. I'll get him to comment on this. Dr. Logan doesn't know I was going to report on this, but mark my words, he'll have a thing or two to say about it. There's an article appearing in the New York Times by Anand O'Connor. Nice article giving the writer attribution. So my reporting on this is based on this article, September 12th, dated today. Title: How the Sugar Industry Shifted Blame to Fat.
It's a cool image, too, on there.
That is a cool image. If you're watching at letstalknutrition.com. Now, what's interesting, let me just take one health issue. Let's take the obesity epidemic. Or you can take heart disease. Whatever. When you start to ask questions about how did it happen, who are the usual suspects, let's take obesity. And we go to the food industry. We say, well, those companies that make these processed foods high in salt, sugar, and fat, they say, not me. Go to the soda industry, it's like all of those, lining them all up in front of a congressional committee and asking each and every one of them, like they did with the tobacco manufacturers and all those presidents, and asked them if smoking caused cancer, and each one of them said no. They lied under oath. These people do the same thing. We're not responsible for the obesity epidemic. Well, how in the hell did all these people, 68% of the population, become overweight or obese? Did it just drop out of the ether? Is that what happened? We started inhaling some particles in the air, and everybody started gaining weight like nobody's business over the last three decades that now make the obesity epidemic one of the most serious, if not the most serious, public health crisis in the 21st century? Who's responsible? They say, well, it's the individual's fault. They're making the choice to eat the cookies, crackers, cakes, chips, colas, cupcakes, Alfredo, sauce, and whatever. They blame it on the consumer. We just make the stuff, they eat it. Really. So nobody wants to take blame or take responsibility. So this article sort of gets at that. So the sugar industry paid scientists in 1960s to play down the link between sugar and heart disease. Here they, I mentioned that. And promote saturated fat, O'Connor says, as the culprit. Instead, apparently they found some newly released historical documents. Yeah. Internal sugar industry documents, O'Connor writes, recently discovered by a researcher at the University of California, San Francisco, was published Monday in the Journal of the American Medical Association Internal Medicine Journal, right? And suggests that five decades, O'Connor says, of research into the role of nutrition in heart disease, including many of today's dietary recommendations, may have been largely shaped by the sugar industry. Now, isn't that sweet? Isn't that so sweet? Quote, they were able to derail the discussion about sugar for decades, close quote. So said Stanton Glantz, G-L-A-N-T-Z, a professor of medicine at UCSF and author of the paper I just referenced. These documents reveal that a trade company called the Sugar Research Foundation, known today as the Sugar Association, paid three Harvard scientists the equivalent of about $50,000 in today's dollars to publish a 1967 review of research on sugar, fat, and heart disease. Yeah, you see, I always tell you, science isn't necessarily, well. The studies used in the review were handpicked by the sugar group, and the article, which was published in this journal, JAMA, prestigious, minimized the link between sugar and heart disease and cast aspersions, O'Connor writes, on the role of the unsaturated fat, close quote. You see? And this is why people lose confidence, not only in government, but in these in the industries that are supposed to, you know, be doing the right thing, having social responsibility, and not shaping public perceptions that lead to falsehoods and misrepresentations, falsehoods, and get people into health trouble. It's unconscionable that they do these kinds of things. But you know what? It's always, you know the old joke, it's not about the money. Oh, yes, it is. It's always about the money. Last year, there was an article in New York Times, and they talked about Coca-Cola the world's largest producer of sugary beverages, provided millions of dollars in funding to researchers who sought to play down the link between sugary drinks and obesity. See, what did I just say? This goes on all day long. I know this because I'm reading this stuff. This is what I do for a living. And, you know, you get so frustrated, you don't know what to say. So I report on it. They probably view me as a gnat. He's no threat. Let him go ahead and report on it. Well, it's not only me. If everybody else in this business would do the same kind of thing and just report it. I'm not lying. I'm reporting. This is what the facts are. The facts are what they are.
As a family-owned company since 1968, Now Foods has spent the last 46 years building a legacy in the natural health industry as a trusted leader. Now provides a comprehensive approach to wellness by offering more than 1,400 high-quality health foods, supplements, sports nutrition, and personal care products at an affordable price. Now believes that natural is better. They don't use artificial colors, flavors, or sweeteners, and they offer many vegetarian, organic, and gluten-free products. Their foods are all non-GMO. Since their beginning, Now has grown to become an award-winning leader in the natural health industry. But one thing has never changed: their commitment to providing the highest quality products at the best value to empower people to lead healthier lives. High quality doesn't have to mean high price. From essential oils to amino acids, multivitamins to natural sweeteners, Now has you covered. To find a store near you that carries Now products, or for more information, visit nowfoods.com. That's nowfoods.com.
Are you suffering from those awful allergies? Hay fever, sneezing, watery eyes? Here's some advice you won't want to miss.
I'm a doctor, and my patients used to dread allergy season. But then I discovered A. Vogel Allergy Relief, a unique combination of natural ingredients that usually addresses every one of my patients' symptoms. And while it's clear that the vast majority of my patients benefit significantly from A. Vogel Allergy Relief, what's even more amazing is that after using it, at least half of my patients' symptoms didn't return. As a doctor, that's the kind of outcome my patients and I can appreciate.
Get doctor-recommended A. Vogel Allergy Relief for your allergy symptoms. It's proven safe, it doesn't make you drowsy, it's fast-acting, and it may even help prevent your allergies from returning. Available at Vitamin Discount Centers, Richards, Rollin' Oats, Vitamin Shop, Nutrition Smart, and other fine health food stores.
Feel tired, lethargic, or irritable? Take Solace. You're one of millions of Americans that has trouble falling asleep or staying asleep. In fact, according to a national survey, 54% of adults have trouble sleeping. So what can you do about it? Take Solace. Solace is an all-natural dietary supplement formulated to support healthy sleep and relaxation. Solace can help you fall asleep and stay asleep naturally. Formulated with all-natural ingredients, Solace is non-addictive and won't leave you feeling groggy in the morning. Take Solace an hour before bed and feel the calming effects of this extensively researched sleep and relaxation aid. For more information on Solace, call toll-free 877-533-7066 or visit TakeSolace.com. That's 877-533-7066 or TakeSolace.com. Look for Solace in your local health and nutrition store. Solace, for a good night's rest naturally.
When you're passionate about your health, that passion leads to the knowledge that exercise and a healthy diet are not always enough. Sometimes you need the extra nutritional boost that only supplements can provide. If you are looking for the leading national brands of vitamins, supplements, health and beauty, weight loss, or sports nutrition products, look no further than Vitamin Discount Center. Voted Best Independent Chain by Vitamin Retailer Magazine, Vitamin Discount Center has been a trusted and valuable nutrition resource to the Tampa Bay area for over 15 years. With daily savings up to 50%, Vitamin Discount Center offers the best prices on the highest quality nutritional supplements. Not only will you find unbeatable value, your visit includes access to a staff educated on the application of products to help equip you with the products and information you need to proactively improve your health. To locate the store nearest you, visit vitamindiscountcenter.com, as well as access to articles on popular health topics, promotions, events, and thousands of products to shop from right at home. Your search for an affordable solution to better health is finally over. Vitamin Discount Center. For life, for less.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by AlgaLife, algae for life. CV Sciences, from seed to shelf. New Chapter, the benefit of nature's wisdom. Yerba Prima, pioneers in internal cleansing. Form Essentials, makers of the sleep aid Solace. Now introducing Zinnia for healthy hair, skin, and nails. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Welcome back. Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. Dr. Alan Logan's my guest. You know, throw that up on the screen for me, Josh. Alan Logan. There he is. And he's with Genuine Health as opposed to Disingenuous. No such company. Dr. Logan, welcome back to Let's Talk Nutrition.
It's great to be with you, Dr. Garko, and what a incredible story this is that you've presented from the New York Times.
You're not going to hear it in the mainstream media. I'm glad that the New York Times is reporting on this. There's more to the story, Dr. Logan. I want to get your reaction. Just as a sidebar, one of the researchers that was paid to downplay the connection between sugar and heart disease, his name was D. Mark Hegsted. He was one of the scientists that was paid by the sugar industry. Guess what? He went on to become the head of nutrition, I'm not making this up, at the United States Department of Agriculture, where in 1977 he helped draft the forerunner to the federal government's dietary guidelines.
Yeah, this is where the whole thing is so insidious. And you really pointed out that the key thing here, and that is it's just constant deflection. You know, it's merchants of doubt. Get into the brain of the consumer that there's doubt around this research, and yet we live in an era when type 2 diabetes is so common that individuals on television with these direct-to-consumer ads on TV for type 2 diabetes medications, that they know what A1C levels are. I mean, it's just like it's a routine little thing that you chat about with your friends.
20 years ago, A1C... they wouldn't have known if you could have held a gun to the head and said, tell me what it – now you could ask a cab driver. And he said, oh, yeah, my A1C is.
Exactly. So that this is sort of a little surrogate marker of how disgusting this whole thing is. And there's something else that's embedded in that important article as well. And you also have made this clear in the way you've presented it. It's not over. I don't want the reader of this New York Times article or the listener to presume for one second that this is just some sort of historical footnote that existed in the 1960s through to those early guidelines. And it said, not at all. It says right in the article that there's ongoing efforts poured into millions of dollars of funding into research that is clearly swaying different directions, right? I mean, and you can also look at what's going on in California right now with simple efforts to provide a minuscule amount of tax onto soft drink purchases that are being completely twisted. I mean, the way that this is being slanted by the sugar industry is profound. So, I mean, and again, and then let's talk about the realities that marketing is causally implicated. That means that there is enough evidence within public health criteria that shows that marketing to children influences the outcomes of their dietary choices.
No question.
So stand by idly now, knowing that this science is in place, and yet industry gets to self-regulate itself. Right?
It's amazing. Oh, it's amazing. I mean, and you try to raise the consciousness. Now, the mainstream media, all the major networks, for all the cable, for all the new major newspapers. You know, here's the New York Times. I don't know how many people are going to read this article and what they'll make of it, but the implications of it are really manifold. As you pointed out, type 2 diabetes. We can go on and on. All the diseases connected to the just added sugar to food. Michael Moss's book, Dr. Logan, Salt, Sugar, and Fat, that... He's a wonderful journalist. That book came out about 2 years ago, and I reported on it then. It's a wonderful book. These food companies have more PhDs working for them than you and I collectively have since. And they're
without a doubt.
They're figuring out how they're coming up with these new combinations of salt, sugar, and fat, different kinds of salt. People think there's only one kind. No, there's not. There's different kinds of salt. Yeah. They figured out the bliss point, exactly how much sugar to put in a food to get you addicted. It's astonishing. People don't, it's just business.
I know. I completely agree. And it's fascinating to me. It's always fascinated me, to your point, that there are PhDs in psychology that graduate all together in the same class. And one group will go off and work for industry and with lots of clever different ways to increase the purchasing of clearly unhealthy foods and beverages. And yet there's another little army that goes out and tries to work with people who are already overweight in order to try and change their behavior and their dietary patterns. It's just absolutely mind-blowing to me that you have the same profession manipulating the environment to create the problems and then manipulate, trying to undo that to try to help people. It's absolutely profound.
I know.
And, you know, while we're on topic, I would encourage a hero of mine is Dr. Susan Prescott, MD, PhD. She's a pediatrician. She's an immunologist. And whenever these things come up, she calls it out big time on her Twitter feed. And I would encourage people to go over there and see this. She's already got that up there. She has the other things we've been talking about here today and is a gutsy. Because these are the problems that she sees in her clinic. So the real world where the rubber hits the road, right? Irish children exposed to 1,000-plus TV ads for high sugar, right? And yet the world continues to rotate. We cannot allow industry to self-regulate itself. It doesn't work. There's zero evidence to show that it works.
Yeah, I mean, it's a definition for insanity. It's one definition of insanity. We come back. We'll talk to Dr. Logan in a more optimistic sense. We'll talk about genuine health, your genuine health, and the company as well. And what's the connection between your brain and your intestines?
When your alarm goes off, do you jump out of bed with excitement? Or does it take multiple alarms, a few snooze buttons, or a morning caffeine fix to get you going? These habits and daily stress cause a vicious cycle in which sleep becomes increasingly elusive. In fact, 54% of Americans report struggles to fall or stay asleep. For a better night's rest, look no further than Solace, an all-natural dietary supplement that supports healthy sleep and relaxation so you get the rest you need to wake up clear-eyed, alert, and ready for the day. Solace has given thousands a better night's rest and the power to take back their mornings while enjoying the day ahead of them. Solace is formulated with non-addictive, scientifically proven, all-natural ingredients that support sleep and relaxation, such as melatonin, tryptophan, and 5-HTP. For more information or to order Solace, visit TakeSolace.com. Solace, for healthy sleep, naturally.
Looking for the perfect complement to your beauty regimen? Try Form Essentials Zinnia. The finest of its kind, Zinnia offers twice as much biotin as other formulas, which has proven to unlock the vibrancy in even the dullest of hair, skin, and nails. Zinnia breaks through and rejuvenates cells internally, helping you achieve the allure of effortless beauty. Reviving your hair, skin, and nails has never been easier. This essential blend of biotin, alpha lipoic, and hyaluronic acid, collagen, and vitamin C creates lasting enhancements to your natural good looks. Don't go on wondering, you're worth the results. This combination of ingredients can only be found in Zinnia. Pamper yourself with a proven bit of affordable luxury and start looking your best. Ask for Zinnia by name at your nearest vitamin retailer to begin your journey to restored nails, head-turning hair, and radiant skin today. For more information, visit formessentials.com.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Now Foods, Our Products Work, American Biotech Labs, your daily immune system support, Renew Life, the digestive care company, Country Life, a leader and authority in natural health and nutrition, Enzymedica, the enzyme experts, North American Urban Spice, the only oregano oil you can take on a daily basis, Let's Talk Nutrition, on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Welcome back. Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. Dr. Alan Logan's my guest. He's a consultant for Genuine Health and pretty good company. They have an interesting approach to their dietary supplement food products. He'll explain. It ties into a theme that Dr. Logan wants to explore today, and that is this, what they call the gut-brain, gut microbiota, gut-brain axis. Yeah, microbiota, gut-brain axis. Sometimes they just say gut-brain axis, but microbiota are implicated in this axis. You know, these bugs that live in your gut, you know, the probiotics and whatnot. And so this is interesting in that the microbiome is now in this area of research is being shown to be a determinant of behavior and cognition. And in a review article by Foster and some other researchers where they talk about this gut microbiota and brain function connection, point out that the brain, the development of the brain itself in an infant, for example, has been shown to be influenced by the microbiome. And as such, the researchers write, the communication of the gut microbiota with the brain through what is referred to as the microbiota gut-brain axis represents a new biological axis by which novel diet-based therapies can be designed to influence brain function and behavior, close quote. This implicates everybody listening to the show. Typically, people think that the brain, the nerve central, you know, the central nervous system, your brain and everything related to it, it is not connected to any, you know, it's just managing everything else, but it's intimately and inextricably connected to what's going on in your gut. Dr. Logan, welcome back. In a word, could you talk about that connection and how you perceive it and describe and explain it?
Sure. And again, thank you very much for correctly identifying me as a consultant to Genuine Health and not an employee. I have no vested interest financially with their product sales or anything like that. I have been a longstanding consultant, so thank you for getting the facts correct on that, as
sure.
usual. Yes, the gut-brain microbiota connection, once sort of laughed off. For many years, prior to the early 2000s, the thoughts scientifically surrounding a gut-brain connection was strictly what is called top-down. So people with irritable bowel syndrome, people with, you know, chronic digestive complaints and so forth, it was always thought that, well, it's only because you're stressed or, you know, perhaps... you're not living your lifestyle correctly, that you're getting these complaints. It's your own fault in many ways, actually. There was a lot of fault. If you go back into the history of irritable bowel syndrome and its research, I mean, you had psychoanalytical theories that were basically saying, hey, it's in many ways about your conflicts during infancy and so forth. That has now been completely turned on its head. It's not to say that there isn't an influence of stress going downwards and influencing the gastrointestinal tract. It can and it does. But it could also work the other direction, that the makeup of the microbial profile in the gut may actually be influencing the way in which the brain works, because we've identified a variety of different pathways by which microbes can communicate with the brain both directly and indirectly. And I'll go through them in very brief here. First of all, they protect the intestinal lining. And in the absence of a wonderful array of diverse microbes, if you lose the diversity, this is very much, Dr. Garko, like the external environment. Diverse environments are healthy environments. And the same thing is true, generally speaking, in the gut. And when you lose the diversity, and you lose it through the westernized diet, you lose it through a sedentary lifestyle. You can lose diversity through stress, but certainly antimicrobials, you know, there's so many antibiotics being prescribed, they find their way into our food supply. So those take away diversity, and you lose the protection of the intestinal lining.
And you're talking about diversity of the bacteria that live in the gut.
Yes, exactly. And that, in turn, compromises this wonderful net, this barrier to the outside world that is the intestinal lining. And if it becomes slightly more porous than it should be, you get unwanted material. That in turn leads to an immune response that presents itself as low-grade fatigue, low-grade levels of tension, lowered mental outlook, and slight alterations in cognitive function, in detrimental. So in other words, they have brain fog. It's the walking wounded. But there are other ways too. The influence of the microbes, again, a healthy, diverse population of microbes, promotes nutrition in the blood. You get more phytochemicals, your phytonutrients, they're known as antioxidants. They don't really like that term because they're far and away, these colorful components of berries and deep-colored plant foods are far and away more than just antioxidants.
That's right.
They do so many different things, including, and this is mind-blowing, recently researchers have shown, at least experimentally, that they could actually leave slightly more serotonin or dopamine around the space between the nerves, and that is like having a little minuscule drop of an antidepressant medication. I mean, at least experimental. We don't know that in humans yet. But there is also direct communication between the microbes and right up to the brain via the vagus nerve, which is absolutely a game changer. So this whole aspect of from gut upwards now, so it's bottom up, if you will, and that's how they refer to it, literally, is changing everything. And just in one quick second, I can tell you, this is, again, in an animal model, but when they take animals that are a bit more brave, these are Swiss NIH mice, as they're called, and when they take the microbiota from the gut of those animals and implant it into more timid mice, right, or they're called Balb-C mice, those mice take on the traits of the more brave, if you will, quote-unquote, Swiss NIH mice. And the reverse happens, where you take the gut microbiota from these more timid Balb-C mice, implant it into the Swiss mice that are typically a bit more aggressive, if you will, or certainly willing to wander into open space and so forth, be a bit more brave. They then become more timid. They're not willing to take the chances
okay.
that one would. So, again, it's animals, but you're seeing what could happen here.
Okay, and I get it, and I'm all in. Let me ask you as a sidebar question. Some people, I know this goes on because people ask me and tell me and whatnot, comment on it. When I report on studies that are animal studies, these pre-clinical trial studies, where you whether they be in a test tube. Petri dish or with animals, they say, well, what's the, you know, you're talking about mice. This has nothing to do with humans. When we come back, if you could just make a brief comment about why animal research has relevance and is of any practical importance to humans and how that fits into the scheme of the science narrative and pathway ultimately to humans. If we could, you do that when we come back,
we'll transfer to humans on the other side.
Okay, good. Meaning of this commercial, not of our life.
At Country Life Vitamins, we've been helping people live happy, healthy lives since 1971, and we believe integrity should always be our number one ingredient. We are committed to this belief because you deserve high-quality nutrition, specifically crafted with the highest standards to support your health. Country Life's manufacturing facility is an NSF GMP-registered facility, as well as USDA-certified organic, so you can feel good about the products you're taking. Country Life Vitamins is also the first supplement company in the United States to have a complete line of products certified gluten-free. That's over 500 products. Country Life Vitamins' pledge of integrity is based on 5 standards: authenticity, cleanliness, freshness, consistency, and accuracy. Ask for Country Life's top-selling products, such as Coenzyme B Advanced for increased energy or Flex Able for joint health. Country Life Vitamins' commitment to ensure all of our products are pure, wholesome, gluten-free supplements full of natural goodness provides peace of mind with the knowledge you are using a brand you can trust.
Feeling tired after your meal? Occasional gas, bloating, or indigestion at inopportune times? You may have an enzyme deficiency. Did you know that many common digestive discomforts can be caused by poor digestion? When food isn't completely digested, it begins to ferment in the digestive tract, which may cause uncomfortable symptoms. Digest Gold, America's number one selling enzyme product, offers unparalleled support for your digestive needs. It contains exclusive blends of enzymes optimized to be 3 times stronger and work more than 6 times faster than other leading digestive supplements. With just 1 capsule per meal, Digest Gold offers support to break down carbohydrates, fats, fiber, and protein. Enzymedica products are all natural, vegetarian, contain absolutely no fillers, and are vegan and kosher when possible. You'll find Digest Gold and other Enzymedica products at fine health food stores near you. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
Still looking for your fountain of youth? It's Zinnia. Look no further than the beauty aisle of your favorite health and nutrition store. Zinnia is the newest product from Form Essentials, the brand that brought you Solace. So you know it's filled with the highest quality ingredients. Many cosmetic products only treat topically, while Zinnia addresses aging and hair loss from within. Formulated to support the growth of radiant hair, skin, and nails, Zinnia is sure to help you turn back the hands of time and assist you in aging gracefully. Zinnia provides a spectrum of key vitamins and other evidence-based natural ingredients such as alpha lipoic acid, biotin, and collagen and elastin peptides, all combined in one capsule for your convenience. By promoting beauty from the inside out, you're strengthening your cells and creating a lasting enhancement to your natural beauty. Zinnia fits into your daily routine and can be taken to boost your current cosmetic products. Available now at leading health and nutrition stores, ask for Zinnia by name. Start taking Zinnia hair, skin, and nails today and get ready to look amazing.
The latest trend to hit the store shelves has the whole country buzzing. Cannabidiol, or CBD, might just be the greatest discovery of our generation, and it comes from a plant that is not so new, agricultural hemp. Yes, after 70 years of prohibition and misunderstanding, hemp is back to help you stay healthy and balanced. Growing research is showing that we have a lot to learn from the remarkable hemp plant. Nutrient-rich products like Plus CBD Oil's Total Plant Complex concentrated products provide broad-spectrum nutrition, including fatty acids, plant sterols, cannabinoids, terpenes, and naturally occurring vitamin E. From seed to shelf, all Plus CBD Oil products provide the highest quality hemp-derived CBD products available and are offered in a variety of delivery systems and flavors to suit your needs. Ask your local independent health food store about Plus CBD Oil products by CV Sciences today and learn more about the CBD evolution at pluscbdoil.com. That's pluscbdoil.com.
Natural Factors presents.
Hi, I'm Dr. Michael Murray. How would you like to feel more calm, centered, and alert with greater mental focus and clarity? Pharma-GABA, a special natural form of the major brain chemical GABA, can help. Our brain can naturally produce GABA, but sometimes we don't produce enough. So taking it as a supplement can give your brain a GABA boost. Pharma-GABA is a clinically proven form that is considerably more effective than other forms. Pharma-GABA produces favorable changes in brainwave patterns as well as a dramatic reduction in markers of stress, including salivary cortisol levels. Pharma-GABA is fast-acting with feelings of calmness and mental focus experienced within 5 minutes of taking Pharma-GABA. So, if you want to feel calmer with greater mental clarity and focus and need a fast-acting help to cope with a stressful day, give Pharma-GABA a try. I think you'll be glad you did.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Nubian Heritage, Global Healing, Modern Wellness. BSN, Finish First. Nordic Naturals, Pure and Great Tasting Omega Oils. Jaro Formulas, Superior Nutrition and Formulation. Natural Factors, Where Great Health Begins. Kyolic, Aging Makes the Finest Garlic Truly Odorless. A. Vogel, Europe's Leading Brand of Herbal Medicine. Let's Talk Nutrition, on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Welcome back and welcome to the show if you just tuned in. Dr. Logan was just explaining in a very clear way the importance of your gut microbiota, the microbiome, in other words, the bacteria that live in your gut, your intestinal lining. And there are always these, for lack of a better way to say it, these good, healthy bacteria, good bacteria, are always in a battle and an overall war for terrain and food in your gut, the pathogenic bacteria. And he explained why these bacteria are so important and how they can connect to your cognitive function and hence to your mood and behavior. Research is supporting that. Dr. Logan, welcome back. And at Genuine Health, I'll get to that question about animal research in a second, but at Genuine Health, they have dietary food supplements that will help with the gut microbiota, yes?
They have fermented products, fermented protein powder, fermented protein bars. They have a fermented food blend, which is whole body nutrition, includes things like fermented kale. And the idea there is allowing microbes to go to work to create something that could be more beneficial, including to what it may do once it arrives down inside the gastrointestinal tract. But when you use microbes to your advantage and through fermentation of plant foods, you actually can render them much more efficient in terms of bioavailability of proteins, i.e. getting more of those important amino acids in the bloodstream by getting more of the phytochemicals or the phytonutrients, the colorful components that give plants their taste, their texture, and their color.
Sure.
Those things work are critical to various tissue throughout the body. And if you use microbes to your advantage, you can get more of those to the target tissue. So that's what they're kind of in the business of, if you will, is using microbes to, you know, ancestral or traditional artisanal fermentation technique and applying it to sort of modern supplements.
So when you ferment food, let me ask it this way. When food gets fermented, is it because of the bacteria, or do they create bacteria, the fermentation create bacteria, or both? What's the relationship?
Well, the microbes act upon any type of carbohydrate component that might exist,
okay.
Right? So they love that. It's food for them, and they'll go to work and essentially transform that food. Now, in the process, you can create the development of growth of more microbes as they go about their business.
Okay.
They begin to start to replicate. But you have to have the microbes first.
To start off. Okay. So bacteria, they've been around since the beginning of the earth.
They have.
And so have viruses, and that's a conversation for another day. But if you go to genuinehealth.com, the protein bars are great. The powders to make the shakes and the food, that one food product that they have, these are fabulous products because they're really fermented foods. And I don't know how many of you listening and watching the show are in the business of daily finding ways to eat fermented foods. There are some listeners and viewers that do. I'm not one of them. I confess, and neither is Dr. Logan. He confessed to that too.
No, can't do it.
Can't I? Who has the time? I don't have the time, and I don't have the patience. I got, you know, it's all I can do just to do what I'm doing. So this is a nifty way to get fermented foods into your daily dietary regimen, and the bars, the products taste great, and they work. It's not the end all and be. It's not going to answer all health questions, but it's an interesting dietary supplement food strategy or tactic that you can insert into your regimen and do well with it. Sold in fine health stores throughout the United States. So, Dr. Logan,
go ahead.
Animal studies.
Yeah.
Why are they important, even though they are ranked at the nutritionists typically rank animal studies at the bottom of the list and then clinical trials at the top, that research pyramid that you're familiar with, I know.
Sure.
Animal studies are at the bottom. Why?
Yeah, they need to remain there, quite frankly, because we're not rodents. And, you know, there's a big, they're wonderful in the sense that they can outline various pathways. And we need to know mechanisms. You need to understand how it is that a certain probiotic, you know, if we're going to then start to push this research into that direction, where we're talking about a medicinal agent, if you will, being orally consumed, well, we kind of need to know how that works. Because otherwise, we're just feeling around in the dark, and the gut is just a black box then. And we need to have these mechanisms and have a far greater understanding.
Right.
It's still in many ways a black box, but they provide us with the mechanisms. But here's the big difference with why they're still lowly ranked, at least in my opinion. Because as much as I was getting fired up before the break about how fantastical this research is, I also want to temper it with the notion that we're not Swiss mice, or for those who may be joining us, where the microbes transferred from one rodent genetic model to another could influence their behavior. We're not rodents. And here's the thing. The industry that has us like puppets, or marionettes rather, that we talk the top of the hour with, right?
Mm-hmm.
Rodents don't walk out of their little caves into an environment with billboards and sidewalk signage and constant marketing to eat more sugar, to consume more highly and ultra-processed foods. So whatever we learn about the gut-brain axis, it's always going to come back to the fact that we need to adhere to the principles of traditional dietary habits, which set the stage for better and more diverse gut microbiota to begin with.
Right.
See, this is the part that never gets discussed by the you know, the engineers who look out and say, wow, this is really remarkable. We could create pills that might influence mental health. And I wish them well. I hope that that happens. But the likelihood of success, as you and I both know, of that happening is diminished when we live in a world where you're, as I have called it in published research on my own, dysbiotic drift, that we live in this world where all of the environmental forces are stacked against us, which is very important why you started this show with the fact that industry is allowing us to consume sugar at no end. But guess what? That sugar alters the gut microbiota.
Yeah, in the world of communication, it's always said context is everything. And in an ironic way, we're asking people to be healthy and to live a healthy life in a context in which things are not healthy and the protocols are not healthy and encourage an unhealthy life. It's crazy. It's like trying to raise good children in a bad neighborhood and hope that they grow up okay. Probably not. So I'm just saying.
We need the environment to be taken into consideration.
Absolutely. Dr. Logan, thank you so much. Genuine Health, we'll have Dr. Logan back on. That's a very good company. Their products are terrific, wholesome. I use them. They're fermented. Visit their website. Go in your health store. Ask the proprietor, the manager, or the owner to talk to you about Genuine Health and their products. Yeah. Genuine Health. Why? Because your health is your health.
statements made during this broadcast regarding products or the claims made about specific products have not been evaluated by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. Products and treatments discussed are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent disease. Make your physician aware of all nutritional supplements used and immediately notify your physician if you have any health concern or undiagnosed sign or symptom. Let's Talk Nutrition is a health talk show that features scientists, authors, nutrition specialists, personal trainers, holistic healers, and experts in traditional, natural, and integrative medicine. Listen for a chance to win daily prizes and follow Let's Talk Nutrition on Facebook and Instagram at Let's Talk Nutrition or on Twitter at LTN Radio. It's time for some inspiration. Tune in to get fit and healthy. It's time to talk about nutrition. Nutrition for your body, your mind, your spirit. It's time to talk about proper exercise, stress relief, eating well, and supplementation to help. Get ready to take charge of your health because your health is your wealth and the wealth of those who care about and love you. It's time for Let's Talk Nutrition with Dr. Michael Garko. Welcome to the show.
Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. Thanks for tuning in today and hope your day is going well, off to a good start, whatever time of the day it is for you. Show is syndicated across the U.S., so check your local listings for when it airs. Maggie Johnle from Renew Life is my guest today. We were talking about the gut-brain connection in the first portion of the show. Let me see if I can pick that up with her and whatever else is on her mind. Before we go and talk with Maggie, I was reporting on a story in the New York Times today. And if you have time, read the article. It's well worth it. It's by Anahad O'Connor, giving the writer attribution. And the headline on the story is How the Sugar Industry Shifted Blame to Fat. And this is, you can't make this up. Apparently some documents have become revealed, and they are published in the Monday's Journal of American Medical Association Internal Medicine edition today, as of today, published Monday or yesterday. And it's 5 decades of research, these documents reveal, into the role of nutrition in heart disease that implicates the sugar industry. Back in the 1960s, the documents reveal that researchers were paid by the sugar industry to downplay the link connection between sugar and heart disease and promote the idea that it was saturated fat that was causing heart disease and not sugar. That's what these historical documents reveal. Dr. Stanton Glantz, who's a professor of medicine at the University of California, San Francisco, is the author of the study and was able to find these documents. And the documents reveal that a trade group back at the time then was called the Sugar Research Foundation, currently known as the Sugar Association. And there were 3 Harvard professors, Harvard no less. They got about $50,000 in today's dollars to publish a 1967 review of research on sugar, fat, and heart disease. O'Connor in the article points out that the studies were used in the review by these 3 Harvard professors were cherry-picked and then published in the New England Journal of Medicine. In other words, they picked only those studies that would reinforce the idea that it wasn't sugar that was causing heart disease, it was fat. Thinking about the ethical implications of that for a second, and beyond that, how that began to influence the nutritional landscape in our country and in other places in the world, for that matter, making fat the culprit and not sugar. Last year, in the New York Times, it was revealed, O'Connor writes, that Coca-Cola, which is the largest producer of sugary beverages, gave millions of dollars in funding to investigators who sought to play down the link between sugary drinks and obesity. And when you ask these food companies and beverage companies, do you think you have some responsibility for what's going on with the obesity epidemic? No. It's the candy companies. It's the cake companies. It's the individual's fault because they're not taking personal responsibility. We just make the stuff. That's some of the argument that they make. In June last year, the Associated Press reported that candy makers, speaking of candy, were funding studies that claimed that children who eat candy tend to weigh less than those who do not. Now, you have to be about a nitwit. You know, nitwit, to believe that. In other words, you want kids to be slim? Let them eat candy. Or as Marie Antoinette said, let them eat cake. Are you kidding me? Do they think people are stupid? We're not nitwits. This is remarkable stuff. You wonder how does a culture end up with its food culture? This is one of the ways in modern society, in the technological information age, this happens, where views, where beliefs, attitudes, behaviors, emotions are all influenced and shaped by advertising and marketing and campaigns and hidden research and agendas that are unethical, to influence the landscape and to influence the people to buy these products, and which get them into so much health trouble. This is unbelievable. It's more than outrageous. Where's the outrage? Where's the mainstream media? Where the hell are they? Instead, they're off reporting on this stupidities of this political campaign on both sides. And they're consumed and regurgitating and all exercised and foaming at the mouth over stuff like that. And this, except for the New York Times, gets no play. It's journalistic malpractice not to report on this. It affects every single child and adult living in this country. These researchers were from Harvard, and one of them, back then, in 1977, guess where he ended up? He ended up as head of the nutrition at the United States Department of Agriculture. Unbelievable. I shake my head, and I'm saying it is journalistic malpractice. I didn't hear one thing. Not one. I listened all morning. Not one hint, unless I missed it, about this report. Because they're consumed like addicts with this election. And that's all they're talking about. And doing it in a bad way, as a matter of fact, as a journalist, their reporting stinks on both sides. For both sides. It's horrible. I don't know where they went to journalism school, but man, I'll tell you. And I don't know what these networks are doing, but where is it? You would think there was nothing else going on in the world. What about this article? You know, where you have scientists being bought and sold to report false data. What's up with that? Drives me crazy. Well, I'm reporting on it. I don't care. Whatever. And I don't care if there's one person listening, where I know that's not true. But the point is, who's going to say something? Fortunately, the New York Times, it's there. Go read the article. I encourage you to do it. There's more to the story. Scientists are supposed to be above and beyond reproach, right? They're supposed to be objective. Science is supposed to be objective. Science is supposed to be maybe in some ways even a conscience for society. And now you see what goes on. And maybe it goes on more than we realize. Who knows? That's why when I report on some of these studies that come out and these crazy findings, and you're saying, how can that be? It's running against the stream of decades of research, and all of a sudden this study pops up and says, eating candy bars is just fine for kids. They don't get fat. In fact, they're slimmer than the kids that don't eat candy bars. Really?
The ever-increasing stress and toxicity we are exposed to from our environment, diets, and lifestyles make internal cleansing a necessary part of a good health regimen. Founded in 1980, Yerba Prima was the first company to launch a whole-body internal cleansing kit. Since that time, they have continued to develop and manufacture a complete range of all-natural, high-quality fiber and internal cleansing products. By using all-natural psyllium fiber and no harmful stimulant laxatives, all Yerba Prima fiber and internal cleansing products can be used over a long period of time to ensure optimal health and regularity. With nearly 30 years dedicated to all-natural cleansing products, it's easy to see why Yerba Prima is a leader in the fiber and cleansing products category. Learn more at yerbaprima.com, YERBAPRIMA.com, or visit your local health retailer. Yerba Prima, pioneer in internal cleansing products.
Everyone's raving about the newest botanical superstar hitting the store shelves nationwide. Hemp-derived cannabidiol, or CBD, has been receiving a lot of attention for its tremendous promise on human health. Plus, CBD oil by CV Sciences is the trusted brand setting the standards in this newly emerging category of plant-based extracts, offering a variety of hemp-derived CBD oil products that you can count on. In order to make the highest quality CBD oil products available, it is important to manage every step of the supply chain process, from seed to shelf. That's why, from harvesting our EU-certified hemp seeds, to laboratory testing for quality and safety, to producing our exceptional line of products, we are committed to going the extra mile. It is our commitment to you. Join the CBD evolution. Ask your local natural health retailer about Plus CBD oil products by CV Sciences today. Follow us on Facebook and learn more at pluscbdoil.com.
Still looking for your fountain of youth? It's Zinnia. Look no further than the beauty aisle of your favorite health and nutrition store. Zinnia is the newest product from Form Essentials, the brand that brought you Solace. So you know it's filled with the highest quality ingredients. Many cosmetic products only treat topically, while Zinnia addresses aging and hair loss from within. Formulated to support the growth of radiant hair, skin, and nails, Zinnia is sure to help you turn back the hands of time and assist you in aging gracefully. Zinnia provides a spectrum of key vitamins and other evidence-based natural ingredients such as alpha lipoic acid, biotin, and collagen and elastin peptides, all combined in one capsule for your convenience. By promoting beauty from the inside out, you're strengthening your cells and creating a lasting enhancement to your natural beauty. Zinnia fits into your daily routine and can be taken to boost your current cosmetic products. Available now at leading health and nutrition stores, ask for Zinnia by name. Start taking Zinnia hair, skin, and nails today and get ready to look amazing.
When you're passionate about your health, that passion leads to the knowledge that exercise and a healthy diet are not always enough. Sometimes you need the extra nutritional boost that only supplements can provide. If you are looking for the leading national brands of vitamins, supplements, health and beauty, weight loss, or sports nutrition products, look no further than Vitamin Discount Center. Voted Best Independent Chain by Vitamin Retailer Magazine, Vitamin Discount Center has been a trusted and valuable nutrition resource to the Tampa Bay area for over 15 years. With daily savings up to 50%, Vitamin Discount Center offers the best prices on the highest quality nutritional supplements. Not only will you find unbeatable value, your visit includes access to a staff educated on the application of products to help equip you with the products and information you need to proactively improve your health. To locate the store nearest you, visit vitamindiscountcenter.com, as well as access to articles on popular health topics, promotions, events, and thousands of products to shop from right at home. Your search for an affordable solution to better health is finally over. Vitamin Discount Center. For life, for less.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by AlgaLife, algae for life. CV Sciences, from seed to shelf. New Chapter, the benefit of nature's wisdom. Yerba Prima, pioneers in internal cleansing. Form Essentials, makers of the sleep aid Solace. Now introducing Zinnia for healthy hair, skin, and nails. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Welcome back. Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. Great to be with you. If you're a regular listener to the show, from time to time, you know, I can get animated on certain issues. When it comes to conduct of researchers behaving in unethical ways, being bought and paid for by industry, and publishing studies that mislead people to get us into a great health crisis, I get animated.
Yeah, I think the last time you went on a rant, it was over the same deal.
Related.
Similar.
And I get exasperated with journalists. I didn't go to journalism school, okay? But I have a journalistic responsibility in doing this show, and I'll sit down with any of them any day of the week after what I've seen, the way they report, the sensationalism, and I don't know. I'm just saying. Because it's wrong, Josh.
Oh, yeah.
We have kids that are really sick with adult diseases because these little poor little souls are obese. And these companies, to make a profit, are putting the health and the lives of these kids in jeopardy, never mind the adults, too. And it's just, I mean, I almost want to spit. It makes me so mad. It's terrible. Horrible.
Yeah, my daughter being celiac and having stomach problems as it is, we don't give her sugar. At least not when she's at my place, you know.
And, of course, my guest, Maggie Johnle with Renew Life, understands the implications of a diet that's high in added sugar and salt and unhealthy fat. But, you know, she gets it, and it affects your digestive tract, your gut microbiota in ways that people don't even understand. They just don't feel good but don't know why. Maggie, welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. Sorry you have to walk into that heavy, you know, horns beeping, traffic bumper to bumper, and it's very hot.
don't worry, Maggie. I was over here sheepishly hiding in a corner as well.
I know you were. That's just your personality, right?
No, it's not.
That's the joke, yeah.
Yeah. What do you make of that story?
Pretty interesting. No, I mean, I'd like to say that I'm shocked, but I'm not. This is exactly what I sort of suspected happened decades ago when the scapegoat became fat and sugar became minimalized as a culprit in heart disease and obesity and diabetes and you name it. This is what I tell people all the time. So now there's a cool article that kind of sums it up.
Well, it's in the New York Times today, yesterday, September 12th edition. And it's entitled "How the Sugar Industry Shifted Blame to Fat." And by the way, foods high in saturated fat are not off the hook either. I'm just saying, but it does affect the gut microbiota, doesn't it? This all of this sugar that's added to the food
significantly, yeah, in a major way. And that's really kind of where, you know, supplements can come in to help. You know, when people really are confused about diet and when they're just not sure what the right thing is to do. I mean, ultimately, you look at some of the major supplements that have gained a lot of traction, and probiotics have been huge. You know, when all else fails, I mean, try a probiotic, you know?
I know. Can you delineate and sort of sketch how sugar affects the microbiome? You know, the gut environment living in the lining of the intestines?
Yeah. Well, the way I always think about it is, you know, you've got a little microcosm down there in your gut. And even though we talk about it as this small little world inside us, it's vast. There's trillions of bacteria, and each of them require various nutrients to survive. It just so happens that bad bacteria and some of the bacteria that cause illness and obesity and mood disorders and all of the different things we're learning about them now, that the bad guys require sugar. It's a need for them. They even control some of our cravings in the diet for sugar. And so when we feed them, when we essentially just throw more fuel on the fire, there's no wonder why people are getting sicker and sicker. I mean, it becomes more of an issue when you have things like hidden sugars, where people don't even think of it as a sugar, like, you know, like bread, for instance, and pasta, and some of the things that metabolize or essentially turn into sugar that people forget are, in fact, sugar, essentially. So it's a feeding of the bad bacteria, and it's a general degrading of the gut microbiome.
So what happens when you feed the pathogenic bacteria? That army gets larger, both in number and size, each soldier, so to speak.
Yeah, and they have more influence. I mean, you figure if they've got the most food, if they've got the most resources to grow and thrive, they're going to be calling the shots. They become the, you know, sort of the undisputed king, the ruler of the roost, so to speak. And your good bacteria become weakened, and they don't have the nutrients that they need. You know, you think about the alternatives, right? Like sugar feeds bad bacteria and yeast. Well, what feeds good bacteria? Fiber, you know, the exact nutrient that we get the least of in the standard American diet.
Does added sugar, excess added sugar, or an excess amount of added sugar, does it degrade or otherwise damage the lining of the intestines?
In an indirect way, because it's feeding the bad guys, yeah.
When we come back, does added sugar, is it implicated in the gut becoming impermeable or becoming permeable? We'll see.
Looking for the perfect complement to your beauty regimen? Try Form Essentials Zinnia. The finest of its kind, Zinnia offers twice as much biotin as other formulas, which has proven to unlock the vibrancy in even the dullest of hair, skin, and nails. Zinnia breaks through and rejuvenates cells internally, helping you achieve the allure of effortless beauty. Reviving your hair, skin, and nails has never been easier. This essential blend of biotin, alpha lipoic, and hyaluronic acid, collagen, and vitamin C creates lasting enhancements to your natural good looks. Don't go on wondering, you're worth the results. This combination of ingredients can only be found in Zinnia. Pamper yourself with a proven bit of affordable luxury and start looking your best. Ask for Zinnia by name at your nearest vitamin retailer to begin your journey to restored nails, head-turning hair, and radiant skin today. For more information, visit formessentials.com.
When your alarm goes off, do you jump out of bed with excitement? Or does it take multiple alarms, a few snooze buttons, or a morning caffeine fix to get you going? These habits and daily stress cause a vicious cycle in which sleep becomes increasingly elusive. In fact, 54% of Americans report struggles to fall or stay asleep. For a better night's rest, look no further than Solace, an all-natural dietary supplement that supports healthy sleep and relaxation so you get the rest you need to wake up clear-eyed, alert, and ready for the day. Solace has given thousands a better night's rest and the power to take back their mornings while enjoying the day ahead of them. Solace is formulated with non-addictive, scientifically proven, all-natural ingredients that support sleep and relaxation, such as melatonin, tryptophan, and 5-HTP. For more information or to order Solace, visit TakeSolace.com. Solace, for healthy sleep, naturally.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Now Foods. Our products work. American Biotech Labs, your daily immune system support. Renew Life, the digestive care company. Country Life, a leader and authority in natural health and nutrition. Enzymedica, the enzyme experts. North American Urban Spice, the only oregano oil you can take on a daily basis. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Welcome back to Let's Talk Nutrition. Maggie Johnle is my guest, talking about how sugar affects your gut. My question, Maggie, was going into that last set of messages, does the gut become permeable because of excess sugar? Does it damage the lining of the gut?
I think that what happens with excess sugar in the diet is a general increase in inflammation. And where there's additional inflammation in the gut, there could become irritation and more gut permeability. I haven't seen anything conclusive on the direct association, like sugar causes leaky gut. I haven't seen that. But I gotta believe that there's some kind of connection there due to inflammation.
Yeah, it is about the inflammation. And the small intestine becoming permeable has great implications for the promotion of inflammation, doesn't it?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And various other issues. I mean, that there's a lot of evidence that a higher gut permeability can cause things like food allergies and other autoimmune issues as well.
I know there are foods, but you're a supplement company, so let me ask the question. Are there supplements that can help restore, repair, reclaim the integrity of the gut lining so that it doesn't leak?
Well, it's interesting that you say that. We're looking into some research on gut permeability here in our innovation discussions, years out, looking at products we could come out with that involve probiotic bacteria that specifically help with leaky gut. We're a bit far off, but beyond probiotics and just generally assisting with the gut microbiome and its balance, there's things like glutamine. We have a great product called Intestinu, which is it's basically just glutamine powder, and particularly rich in cabbage, for instance, and some of the old folk remedies include things like cabbage soup, you know, and things of that nature to help restore and protect the gut.
Mm. Cabbage soup?
Yeah.
Cabbage. I like cabbage.
Cabbage is good. It's, not talked about a lot, but it's a...
Isn't that, cabbage considered a cruciferous vegetable, isn't it?
Yes, I believe so.
I like cabbage. My mom got me into eating cabbage. She would make different kind of cabbage dishes.
Mm-hmm.
Cabbage and certain beans and whatnot. Oh, man, with onions. And
Getting hungry now, huh?
Oh, yeah. I can cook that up pretty good. So Intestinu.
Yep.
So there are a lot of people listening. They're saying, well, this doesn't relate to me. The only thing leaking around here is my roof and my house. My gut isn't leaking. I don't have gut permeability. What would be some of the signs that somebody is suffering from a permeable or leaky gut, as the phrase goes, saying goes?
Well, what I've heard the most about are, things like food allergies, sort of like all of a sudden sensitivities to certain things. And this happens too, like as you age, you become less and less tolerant of things. Like, you might develop lactose intolerance, for instance, later in your life and wonder, well, what the heck? I've always had milk and it's never given me a problem before. Well, here you are with some developing food sensitivities. That's one. Gas and bloating in general.
Pain? Pain? Celiac disease, talk to somebody with celiac disease, they always talk about the pain and discomfort in very dramatic ways.
Well, I would certainly want to rule that out. You know, if it were me having distinct gut pain, you definitely want to check it out with a physician and see if there's any structural changes or any particular inflammation that could be the cause. In many cases, people do all these things and rule certain things out, and then it's sort of like, well, we don't know. We don't know what's causing it. And in many cases, it's sort of undetected leaky gut or things like IBS, which are sort of the umbrella term for all gut dysfunction these days. So, yeah, there's a lot of different sort of signs and cues that you may need to look into it a
sure.
little bit further.
Some of the common signs, I should say maybe symptoms that you can actually measure and see, or signs as well. Pain is a sign. That's a subjective experience. But constipation, diarrhea, bloating of the stomach, formation of gas, cramps in the stomach after you eat a meal. These could be some signs that the gut has become permeable, are they not?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. 877-897-8255, 877-897-TALK. That's a toll-free number. Talking with Maggie Johnle from Renew Life. She's an educator for Renew Life. So Intestinu would be a good product for the gut. Of course, your probiotics. Does fiber help keep the gut from becoming permeable?
In a roundabout way, yeah, it plays a role because, you know, what people have to realize is that the gut bacteria need food too. They're little living creatures and they've got to have their resources. They've got to be nourished. And to do that, you need adequate fiber in the diet. But a lot of us come up short with fiber in the diet. We require somewhere in the neighborhood of 35 grams a day, and most of us get close to 10 or less.
Mm.
So a supplement really makes a lot of sense. And if you can get yourself a really good soluble fiber supplement that is also a prebiotic, like acacia, for instance, that could be really useful. Plus, there's a lot of prebiotic foods that are also really, really good, like leeks and onions and garlic mm-hmm. and artichoke and things like that.
What are the fiber products that you have? You only have a few minutes or so. I know you have quite a few. What are some of the fiber products that you have at Renew Life?
Well, we have your favorite, the organic triple fiber, which is a really good blend. That has acacia, but it also has oat bran and flax, all organic. But we also have one of my favorites, which is organic clear fiber. That's a clear blending fiber you can add to anything. You can cook with it, you can bake with it, and it's just 100% organic acacia fiber. That's your prebiotic. So you could view that as to go right in line with your probiotic supplementation.
Chronic muscle and joint pains, aggressive behavior, nervousness, vaginal infections, lack of focus or brain fog, memory problems, irritability and frequent headaches, skin issues, you know, breaking out, chronic muscle, as I said, joint pain, diarrhea, bouts of constipation, bloating, gas, and whatnot. These are just some of the some of the symptoms of permeable gut. When we come back, I'll have the LTN health question of the day. You can win a $25 gift card with the right answer.
Battling sinus, bronchial disorders, allergies, and other seasonal irritants can be a constant struggle, making this the season when you need Oreganol P73 the most, nature's most powerful natural remedy. Get the blast of wild nature you need with the only wild Mediterranean oregano extract, Oreganol P73, from North American Urban Spice. After being tested, both the USDA and the FDA agree Oreganol P73 is powerful. North American Urban Spice knows it's powerful as well, and knows P73 is just what you need. When you take P73, you'll experience its cleansing power. You'll smell the fresh, mountain-grown aroma and feel its effectiveness. The Greeks used wild oregano for their health, not just spice, and called it Oroganos, the delight of the mountain. Oreganol P73 is 100% wild, hand-picked Mediterranean oregano. Do not accept cheap imitations made from farm-raised or non-oregano species. Use Oreganol P73 and stay healthy all year long. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration, not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
At Country Life Vitamins, we've been helping people live happy, healthy lives since 1971, and we believe integrity should always be our number one ingredient. We are committed to this belief because you deserve high-quality nutrition, specifically crafted with the highest standards to support your health. Country Life's manufacturing facility is an NSF GMP-registered facility, as well as USDA-certified organic, so you can feel good about the products you're taking. Country Life Vitamins is also the first supplement company in the United States to have a complete line of products certified gluten-free. That's over 500 products. Country Life Vitamins' pledge of integrity is based on five standards: authenticity, cleanliness, freshness, consistency, and accuracy. Ask for Country Life's top-selling products, such as Coenzyme B Advanced for increased energy or Flexable for joint health. Country Life Vitamins' commitment to ensure all of our products are pure, wholesome, gluten-free supplements full of natural goodness provides peace of mind with the knowledge you are using a brand you can trust.
Did you know that the most common form of calcium supplement today is calcium carbonate, also known as limestone? You don't eat rocks as part of your balanced diet, so why would you choose to supplement your bone health nutritional needs with limestone? Our bodies understand and seek whole food sources of nutrition. New Chapter is proud to deliver Bone Strength Take Care, a calcium complex that delivers key bone health nutrients in the form of whole food, not rocks. Bone Strength Take Care also delivers key bone nourishing nutrients, including vitamins D3 and K2. Vitamin K2 is of critical importance as it ensures calcium is placed in the bone where it's needed and stays out of the arteries where it's not. Discover for yourself the whole food bone health alternative to rocks. Bone Strength Take Care, the best-selling natural bone health supplement in America. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
Feel tired, lethargic, or irritable? Take Solace. You're one of millions of Americans that has trouble falling asleep or staying asleep. In fact, according to a national survey, 54% of adults have trouble sleeping. So what can you do about it? Take Solace. Solace is an all-natural dietary supplement formulated to support healthy sleep and relaxation. Solace can help you fall asleep and stay asleep naturally. Formulated with all natural ingredients, Solace is non-addictive and won't leave you feeling groggy in the morning. Take Solace an hour before bed and feel the calming effects of this extensively researched sleep and relaxation aid. For more information on Solace, call toll-free 877-533-7066 or visit TakeSolace.com. That's 877-533-7066 or take SOLUS.com. Look for Solace in your local health and nutrition store. Solace, for a good night's rest naturally.
Feeling tired after your meal? Occasional gas, bloating, or indigestion at inopportune times? You may have an enzyme deficiency. Did you know that many common digestive discomforts can be caused by poor digestion? When food isn't completely digested, it begins to ferment in the digestive tract, which may cause uncomfortable symptoms. Digest Gold, America's number one selling enzyme product, offers unparalleled support for your digestive needs. It contains exclusive blends of enzymes optimized to be 3 times stronger and work more than 6 times faster than other leading digestive supplements. With just 1 capsule per meal, Digest Gold offers support to break down carbohydrates, fats, fiber, and protein. Enzymedica products are all natural, vegetarian, contain absolutely no fillers, and are vegan and kosher when possible. You'll find Digest Gold and other Enzymedica products at fine health food stores near you. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Nubian Heritage, Global Healing, Modern Wellness. BSN, Finish First. Nordic Naturals, Pure and Great Tasting Omega Oils. Jaro Formulas, Superior Nutrition and Formulation. Natural Factors, Where Great Health Begins. Kyolic, Aging Makes the Finest Garlic Truly Odorless. A. Vogel, Europe's Leading Brand of Herbal Medicine. Let's Talk Nutrition, on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Here's the LTN health question of the day. You have the right answer. You can win a $25 supplement gift card. I'm reporting on an article that appeared in the New York Times yesterday. And it talks about how scientists ended up being paid by a particular industry to misrepresent the data, the facts about this particular food ingredient, to downplay its effect on heart health or coronary artery disease, for that matter, specifically. What was the ingredient that the scientists downplayed? Was it sugar, fat, or salt? Which one of those three did they downplay and then vilify another one? I can't tell you either one because that will give away the answer. But which one did they downplay? The effects of which ingredient, which food ingredient, if you will? Was it sugar, fat, or salt? 877-897-8255. 877-897-TALK. The article is, you can find it at New York Times, by the way, how the blank industry shifted blame to blank. Maggie, welcome back. So intestinu, which is it's more than glutamine. There's some other things in that intestinu product.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Some really interesting ingredients like N-acetyl D-glucosamine, which is glucosamine sulfate's cousin, and what it helps with is keeping the cells of the intestinal tract together, really helping its integrity. And then some herbs in there like cranesbill, marigold, things like that, just uh-huh. to kind of protect it.
Okay. And then, of course, that will help heal the lining of your intestine.
Mm-hmm.
A fiber, triple organic fiber from Renew Life, probiotics, of course, and then avoiding the certain foods that we have listed and talked about.
Really scaling back your sugar intake. I mean, mm-hmm. it's tough to do. It feels like a bit of a bummer at times to have to avoid sugar so much. But if you pay attention to the sort of the bigger things, like the carbohydrates in the diet and just refined sugar, it can be a little easier, kind of baby steps.
Mm-hmm. Do you have people call the company Renew Life, which is located in Clearwater, Florida, asking some advice, direction, or comment about how to treat children with leaky gut?
Yeah, we get a lot of calls, and I just got one yesterday, someone looking for a recommendation for a child with fatty liver, and occasionally it comes up, and unfortunately we can't make product recommendations for little kids. We have some children's products, but it comes up a lot.
Mm-hmm. I mean, back 15, 20 years ago, people that were talking about leaky gut syndrome were primarily in the natural products industry, natural health, functional medicine arena. Now, even traditional physicians and traditional medicine is talking about leaky gut. Do you find that to be? I find that to be the case. Do I have a false observation?
It's definitely becoming more and more mainstream. Like I said, we're kind of leading some of the innovation in this department and seeing research on it with regard to probiotics. So it's even being studied, which, I mean, it really wasn't even recognized as a real thing years ago.
Yeah, a lot of people thought it was hocus pocus.
Yeah.
Not so much anymore. Seems like there's more research to support the hypothesis as to what's going on. Let's go to Lansdale, Pennsylvania. You haven't heard from Lansdale in a while. That market is very good for Let's Talk Nutrition. We appreciate it. Teresa, welcome to the show. It's great to have you on, Teresa.
Thank you.
How are you doing today?
Oh, I'm doing well.
Good. Moving into a little bit of nice weather up there.
Oh, it's lovely today.
Yeah. Yeah, it's into fall and not quite as – winter hasn't hit yet.
No, thank goodness.
Yeah, it's coming. So I was reporting on this story in the New York Times, and these scientists from Harvard were paid by this one particular industry to downplay – the industry, what the industry is all about, some particular ingredient. What was that, sugar, salt, or fat that they were downplaying?
It was sugar.
Yeah, they were downplaying the effects of sugar on heart disease or coronary or cardiovascular health, and blaming fat for heart disease. And that really set into motion a number of practices and policies, even by legitimate organizations, health organizations, and to give recommendations to people to cut back on the fat, blaming the fat as the, you know, culprit, the nutritional culprit contributing to heart disease and other cardiovascular issues. It's really outrageous that that happened, and I suspect it's still going on today. We just don't know about it, and I don't know where the journalists are, but they're asleep at the switch. Congratulations. You want a $25 supplement gift card.
Thank you, Dr. Greco.
Yeah. How did you come upon the show? I'm just curious.
Well, I listen to you in the morning. I go to Holly Hill, about a few minutes away from Holly Hill.
Oh.
And I enjoy your show very much.
Well, thank you very much. We appreciate that. Please, when you go into the store, tell them that I send my best regards. That's a pretty popular health store up in that area, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah. And I encourage, I know a lot of health stores listen to the show. I welcome you to call the show anytime you want and to contribute to the conversation.
Thank you.
Yeah, you can tell them that, too. You tell them that they can call any health store. And there are probably hundreds, if not thousands, of stores across the country that come within the reach of this broadcast since it's syndicated. And so I encourage the owners and managers and employees of the health stores to call in. They are a wealth of knowledge, and they're in touch with the consumer. So please call.
Well, you certainly have my attention.
Well, we appreciate that, Teresa. You take care of yourself. Take care of your health, Teresa.
Thank you.
All right. Maggie, thanks so much. Renew Life, renewlife.com. Their products are sold in fine health stores throughout the United States. Take care of your gut. Watch the sugar, added sugar. Watch the added salt. And watch the added unhealthy fat in foods, because your health is your wealth.